Yes, good evening, good morning, good afternoon, wonderful people of Biafra. Depending on your location, wherever you are watching us from, I want you to share this program, share this program, share this program, because this evening we are here live and direct with Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor. I don't think I need to introduce this man, this great Biafran that you are seeing live on this program. It is one-on-one with Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor this evening. And I want all Biafrans to get ready of their questions, those pressing issues that you want to ask Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor in regards to legal terms, in regards to things that is happening within the premises of the country they call Nigeria and outside the Nigeria law. Meanwhile, he is a legal practitioner and he is going to, you know, educate us. He's going to speak to us. He's going to answer some questions from us. And he is going to do justice to a lot of issues that is happening in Biafra land. I hope all of you know who Mazi Ifeanyi Ejiofor is. He is the personal attorney of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and IPOB general attorney who is fighting this battle both on the ground and the outside the shore of the Biafra land. Therefore, like I promised you yesterday, we were supposed to come live yesterday, but because of some unforeseen circumstances that surrounded us, we could not make it yesterday. Then we decided to reschedule it today. And today, he is here as in the heart, one-on-one. And like I promised you people that Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor is going to be here today, that you should get ready your questions. Please, be patient with us, because the way we present our case, the people who present our program may be different from the way you are expecting it. We do things accordingly. We don't entertain any stupid question. What I mean by stupid question is those irrelevant questions. Those questions that you know the answer already and you are still asking just to derail our time or just to take us backward. We don't need it. We need a question that you think that is a pressing issue that so many people doesn't know, that you don't know, that you need to know. That is the kind of question that we'll be expecting from you. Do not ask us irrelevant question here. As I bring back Mazi Ifeanyi Ejiofor, our attorney at law, who is here to speak to us, to each and every one of us that is watching this program. I want you to share, because you are going to learn a lot from the information that our barrister, our attorney, is going to dish out today. I think barrister is going to do a lot of introduction by himself. He's going to answer a lot of questions from me, after which I am going to open the line. Then each and every one of you there that want to, you know, ask his own question, his or her own question, can proceed to call us to ask questions, because barrister is fully loaded, although he's on a hot seat. But I know there's no hot seat that can be compared with the judiciary of Nigeria, where he go and faced the Binta Nyako, and Binta Nyako succumbed. Where he went and faced Kafarati, or what they call him, and today he is dead. I don't know another hot seat that Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor can face that will stand the test of time without him coming out with victory. But however, the hot seat is for us Biafrans to ask him those questions that we need to ask him. Therefore, barrister, I want you to mute yourself and salute Biafrans before I come to bombard you with my questions. Thank you and welcome to the program. Thank you so much. Go ahead.
Good evening. Good evening. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening, everyone. I respectfully thank my brother, Prince Darlington, for this great efforts he's making towards propagating a message which is very fundamental in actualization of our freedom through this program. I commend you. Once again, I'm a thank you. Our prayers are with you. It's obviously that I may not be coming on regularly as you expected, but be assured that our prayers are with you. Because understand also what you are facing. You understand the efforts being made by enemies of darkness, by agent of darkness to suppress you. But God will not allow them to have their way. Thank you. I'm a familiar name and also a familiar face to Omu Chineke. I have been on this program yesterday, but for reasons I explained to my friend Prince, I was unavoidably absent. I was indisposed on health. My doctor said I should take some rest because I've been working on the ground. I've been doing a lot of things, going around, traveling all over the places, and it's for a purpose. So I thank you for this opportunity. Ifeanyi Ejiofor is a humble guy. It's very simple indeed. I had a wonderful, humble beginning. And I put God first in everything I do. In this project, we are anointed by God to be part of this project. And I give God the glory, the thanks and adoration for leading us thus far. I know we are no longer far from that land filled with milk and honey. I've been saying it to people. It's all here with us. It's a function of being persevered. Don't ever lose hope that we are there with you. And it shall surely end in prayer, in the victory. Thank you once again for being live here. And I've explained to my brother that time will be our enemy today, because I have other interviews to be granted this evening. So reschedule the next, probably next 1 hour, 1 hour, 30 minutes. But I said I must be live here to address burning issues and also lay a number of things to rest in the course of responding to your questions. Thank you so much once again. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, our erudite barrister, the man that I respect and love so much. Thank you for coming to Aside Hot, Biafra TV. Thank you for coming to Biafra TV Live. Thank you for coming to speak to Umu Chineke. A lot of them have been waiting to hear from you after your birthday. You remember when you did your birthday last time, you came on this platform. And like you say, the time is going to be of essence. And we are going to make use of the little time that we have. Barrister can only spend 1 hour, 30 minutes with us. That is why by the time I open the platform for you to call in, I will open our line. Please, you only have 2 minutes, only 2 minutes. Once you ask your question, I will disengage you. Then you go to the background and listen to the answer that he's going to give to us. But before we continue, Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor, I would like you to reintroduce yourself once again. Who is Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor? Hold on, hold on. Yeah, continue, continue. Now I have unmuted you. Go ahead. Who is Barrister Ifeanyi
Ejiofor? Is a simple guy with a humble beginning on a mission and divine mandate to reinvent our very essence and define our purpose and reclaim our destiny. And also, by the special grace of Chukwuka Abiamu, I have been anointed to be part of that 100 persons that will contribute through my own field of study, discipline, towards actualization of Biafra. I hope you understand the manner in which it is being explained. So, and I'm there, have been resolute, and there's no going back. We are moving, marching forward. For whatever,
thank you.
Whatever. Happy moment to Umu Chineke once again.
Thank you so much. Great man you are. I know indeed that you are one of the 100 men that we are called. And having explained yourself to the world, I want you to tell us who is Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to you.
Thank you. This is a very difficult question indeed. Because Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is not a mere mortal in a very simple form. It's not a mere mortal. My personal touch with him shows me that he's not a mere mortal. And he cannot be defined or introduced in a manner in which other persons have been introduced. Nnamdi Kanu is being ordained by God. He's on this earth on a God-directed mission. And he cannot conveniently, conveniently say that Nnamdi Kanu is a person born on Nkwa Day, or Eke Day, Holy Day, or Afo Day. But it's a man that cannot be fully defined. But I can say that Nnamdi Kanu is a prophet of God. Nnamdi Kanu is an agent of God, a man with a compelling character, a man with a compelling integrity, a man who operates in metaphysical. He knows the unknown, and hear direct from God and communicate to others. So he has my respect any day, anytime. He also have my prayers any day, anytime. That is the much I can say about him, because if I start to introduce him Nnamdi Kanu to you people, this 1 hour, 30 minutes given to me to just participate in this program may not be enough for me to explain to you what I know about him. Thank you so much.
That's good. Thank you, sir. Thank you very, very much. I know that Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is an enigma, a colossus. He have a lot of name ascribed to him and a lot of potentials. Thank you, sir. And once again, I would like to ask you one question that is bothering me. We all knew that it was as a result of attack that took place in Mazin Nnamdi Kanu's house that took the life of his both parents, Eze Iho Kanu and the Eze Nwanyi Nneme Sale Ugoeze Nwanyi Ukwu Kanu. And the same thing happened in your own house. And your mother, our mother, was at home on that particular day that this thing happened. I want to know, and Biafras will want to know, what is the situation of your mother's health after that heinous attack meted on you and your family on that very day? What is the situation of her mental and physical health today? Please, the world may would like to know.
Thank you so much. It is really traumatic for her. I recall that she sustained a blood wound during the course of the bloody onslaught in my home, carried on by the enemies of God, assassins in uniforms. But your prayers, the prayers of Umu Chineke, has been so impactful. She's alive today. But once in a while, she remembers. She's still in shock, as a matter of fact, and that she's recovering from the injury sustained, because she's being subjected to periodic medical checkup and also still undergoing medical treatment as a result of the injury she sustained. So she's home now. She's good health wise, not without undergoing medical treatment, regular periodic one. So, having said that, it's also important to emphasize and at the same time appreciate the prayers of my fans, Umu Chineke and Mazin Nnamdi Kanu has been praying for him, for her, right from the word go. He speaks with her regularly to find out how she's doing. And as I can tell you now, that mama classified, as adopted Mazin Nnamdi Kanu as her first son. As a matter of fact, she addresses him as my first son. Whenever she wants to speak with him, he will ask me to call her first child. I want to hear from him. That is the position. Everybody around me will confirm that to you. So, and each time she hears from him, she'll be strengthened and emboldened them all. Thank you so much.
Thank you. And from your explanation, I am happy, and I believe that Biafrans that are watching this program are also happy that Mama is strong. She is our mother. And from what you just said, now I don't need to ask you her stance in Biafra restoration. Already, from what you have just said, I am 100% convinced that she was there during the war, and she know what they went through, and she still support his son and stood by him and still standing by you. So I believe the spirit of Biafra is going to protect and guide Mama, and she's going to live to see Biafra, in the name of Chukwu Kikamia.
Amen. Yes, sir.
So, and going forward, Barrister, you know, as time is of essence on our side, I have some important information, important questions that I would like to ask you. Those questions may be a little bit hard, but I will beg that you should at least know how you can, you know, bring it down, because a lot of people want to hear. And our viewers, please, when we ask a question that you intended to ask, if barrister have answered it, when I open my line, you don't need to repeat the question again, since you have answered the question. So that is another thing that you people have to understand. So the first question I want to ask you, please, Biafrans, I would like you to update Biafrans in the case that you, Mazi Ejiofor, instituted at the Federal High Court, Oka, against the security agencies that invaded your ancestral home in Orifi, in Anambra State. So I would like you to, you know, give us update, because everybody is asking, has that case gone under the carpet? Have they stripped it off, or what happened? Please try to update us. We need to know about that case and what is happening in regards to that case. Go ahead, sir.
Thank you, Prince. You know, shortly after the invasion of my premises, my ancestral home, and the killing of innocent and armed Biafrans, I filed an action before the Federal High Court to challenge the heinous activities of the agent of darkness and the evil ones that invaded my premises. So the matter came up severally, without taking much of your time, because I know if I go into this explanation or probably the history of what has taken place since the matter was in court, it will take a long time. But let me be very brief in response to this. In the course of the hearing, preliminary hearing of the matter, the people that came to my house, the criminals that invaded my premises, the assailants, denied ever killing anybody in my house, because they killed 4 persons in my house. And as God may have it, because after killing those people, they went after their bodies. And as God may have it, the people around were able to remove, evacuate their bodies, dead bodies, before the criminals came. Our application was made before the court to grant direct a reputable hospital within the state to conduct autopsy, and that autopsy was conducted, and consequently the report confirmed impeccably that their death was on account of the bullet injuries sustained during the attack. They were killed, and the report was made available to the court. In fact, the most interesting part of this report is the fact that the chief medical pathologist that authenticated the report stated in the report that any police officer who denied ever shooting or killing the persons whose autopsy has been conducted, was conducted by him, should be charged for contempt. It's in the report. Be charged for contempt. So these are now before the court. And interestingly, last adjourned, the lawyer representing the police ran away from the court. He didn't come, despite service of year notice on him on the matter. He didn't come. He was called in open court. He ran away, yes, he didn't come. He was called in open court. He said he was tired, he can't come. But they said he must come. The court insisted he must come to court. He must come to defend their matter. So, yes. And the court decided to accommodate him for another date. So it's now coming up on the 18th of March this month for definite hearing. This month is coming up on the 18th of March, 18th for definite hearing. So there's no escape route. There's no escape route for anybody again. Everything and I'm before the court. No going back, no more, no less. So we are progressing. And I know it, but I'm just unfortunate that the misinformed has taken acting on the strength of that open justice order. Killed some innocent souls under the guise of implementing the order prescribing IPOB. That is the highest price we can pay. I can assure you justice will be served in that matter. By next tomorrow, we'll take our applications fully and a day to be given for the judgment. And I'll keep on updating you as we progress. And most preferably through this platform, because I believe this platform, a lot are going to be heard through this platform. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Barrister. And thirdly, we would like to know the last time our leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu case and that of Benjamin Madubuwu, Bright Chimezie, Chidebere Onwudiwe, David Nwawisi came up before the Federal High Court. And what happened? Why didn't the court sit? And that is first. And secondly, what is the position of the matter? And what should Biafra be expecting from that case?
Thank you. The matter came up, you know, shortly before Christmas, 2020 Christmas, December. There was a kind of an arrangement by the state to do the untowards. So overnight, a date was given without reference to me, with the lead counsel in the matter, but without reference to other lawyers. They went through our back and obtained and secured a date for the hearing of the applicant of the matter. So we got to know about it a few hours before the date the matter came out. Actually, sometime 23rd of November last year. So a few hours before the date of the matter. And I said no. I wrote to the court. I said no. This hasn't been heard of. A matter as serious, as sensitive as this, a date will be given to prosecution without reference to us to get our clients notified in time that our matter is coming up for hearing. And I will object it. The matter didn't go on. So portion to which the matter was done adjourned to January 25th. That should be on January 25th. Yes, the day after my birthday. So they came up a day after my birthday. Then they caught the seat and no reason was given. What I heard was that the court is indisposed on head ground. So, and adjourned further to 30th day of March 2021 for hearing. Though we have 5 series of applications before the court. First of all, challenging the territorial jurisdiction of the Honorable Court to continue to hear the matter. These applications are very compelling in each nation. And the court must hear this application and rule upon it before we take any further step. Other orders, and I consider them illegal orders and non-constitutional orders made by the court, with respect to his lordship. We have also filed an application to get those orders as it affects my client, Nnamdi Kanu, to get the orders strike out. Because the application, the order on the production of Nnamdi Kanu, or an application filed by the Federal High Court to revoke his bail, cannot be separated by the matter before the Court of Appeal, which has to do with an application filed by the sureties inviting the court to investigate what happened in his premises on the 14th of September 2017, during which the military, combined team of the military, and other security agents invaded his premises and killed not less than 28 persons, burned houses, and did lots of atrocities. So, because this is a person who was willing to be in court on October 14th, 2017, when the matter was stated to be heard. He had also proceeded to notify his fans to make sure that join him in court on that day. That's a sufficient indication of interest to be in court on the day the matter was stated for hearing. But instead of waiting for him to come to court, he now went to his house to kill him. So the circumstances surrounding that bloody invasion of his premises was home on September 14th should be investigated by the court before taking further step. Because if at all, had it been they succeeded in killing him in the manner in which they killed over 28 persons, innocent members of IPOB, unarmed civilians, we won't be talking about this case today. The other simple, we won't be talking about it. Because what they want to achieve is they want to send themselves to early grave, because they were unable to achieve it when he was in prison. One, they were unable to achieve it when he was arrested. Two, so they find it a convenient place to throw by the guise of Operation Python Dance to attack him.
But God said no, because Kabi Yama sent and come to this earth for a special mission. So the matter, as I said, is coming up on 30th of March. And I can confirm to you that we are fully ready for whatever legal onslaught we are going to have on that day. We are ready. And I'll keep on updating Biafra France as we progress. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, Barrister. As you can see, our leader, the information I'm getting from the inside source says that our leader is live right now. And as the protocol demands, there's no how our leader will be live speaking to the world.
Like to.
Live too. So I so much appreciate you for honoring this Kremlin call. And I want you to know that this interview is not complete. This is a half interview. So we are going to reschedule when I'm going to bring it back so that we can finish and people call in to be able to ask you questions. Please. I want you to know that I do appreciate your time and everything you have done. We love you so much for everything you
Thank
are
you
doing.
So, much.
So may you so much. Bless you. Let us hook up with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's broadcast so that the world may know that we give honor to whom honor is due. Okay.
Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Thank you so much. I'm ready. I'm ready here anytime, any day. Call me. I'm ready to address you. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you too. God bless you too.
Thank you.